Introducing SiteLog Data Logger. Introduction. The SiteLog is a multi-channel, battery-powered, standalone data logger. The logger records up to 8 megabytes of data and stores them in non-volatile flash memory. The data can be retrieved by SiteView software. It measures and records inputs of voltage, current, thermistor, and thermocouple, etc. The measurements can be from sensors, transducers, transmitters, or other sources. Features: 16-bit ADC, 8 megabytes flash memory, USB and serial port, over 10 years of battery life, wide sample interval selections, alarm and excitation controls, rugged aluminum closure, and conformal coated PCB. Accessing the device and viewing the settings. Use one side of the enclosed USB cable to connect to your computer's USB port. Connect the other end of the USB cable to the USB port of the data logger. You should have SiteView software installed in this computer beforehand. Double-click the SiteView icon on the desktop to launch it. SiteView will automatically detect the data logger and show the icon of the device under the USB communication panel. The name of the icon includes the model number and the serial number of the data logger to distinguish it from other data loggers connected to this computer. Double-click this icon to communicate with the data logger. Upon the success, the data logger status panel will be displayed. The status contains the general, alarm and excitation, and channel-related settings. For these settings, you will know when the data logger has started this logging session, if the logger has stopped, what sampling interval was selected, how many channels are enabled, what equation was selected for each channel, etc. Configuring device for a new logging session. If you decide to start a new logging session, the onboard flash drive memory will be reset. Please always download the data for your existing session before configuring it for a new session. Click Configure to show the configuration dialog. You may change the description, sampling interval, time to start logging, and when to stop logging. You may also change the channel settings such as description, enabling logging, equation, and calibration data, etc. If you want to enable the alarm and excitation controls, you will need to click Alarm and Excitation tab. You can choose how you want the alarm and excitation controls to drive the Alarm 1 and Alarm 2 terminal poles on the terminal block from this pull-down list. You can choose the warm-up delay for the excitation from this pull-down list. You can also select the on and off delays for entering the alarm or going off alarm from these lists. Channel alarm settings are placed where you can set the low and high alarms for each channel. By clicking the OK button, all data in the data logger will be erased. Click Yes to confirm your action. Now the data logger has started a new logging session. Downloading data from the data logger. With the data logger status panel displayed, click Refresh to make sure SiteView is referring to the latest data pointer. Click the Download button. Select if you want to download the data to the system database or a single file. For single SiteView file selection, you also need to choose a file name to save the data to. Choose the time window you want to download. Then click OK to start the download process. A progress bar will be displayed to indicate the progress of the download. A separate graph window will be displayed upon the success of the download. You have successfully downloaded the data from the data logger. Thank you for watching. More information can be found on www.microedgeinstruments.com.